Children, I hope you are safe and healthy at home. So, I'm going to start with my first lecture, that is for reading section. Before we start, I just want to tell you that what exactly is the weightage of this section. Reading section, you already know about that. It's of 20 marks. And note making, which we want to ensure that you should get 8 marks. I just want to repeat it again, you should ensure that you're going to get those 8 marks. So how you're going to get? According to the board marking scheme, it's not nothing to mug up, nothing related to any rote learning. It is just related to your presence of mind. Okay, so step by step I will go along with the marking scheme. First thing is that what you are going to do. You are going to do note making. And you are going to ensure your 8 marks. That is the first goal which we have to set. Now, you just, first of all, according to board, CBSE board, I will give you the time management advice. When you go for your board exam, for final exam, you get your question paper at 10:15. So you have solid 15 minutes. But in those 15 minutes, you can't even write anything in your answer sheet. So how you can utilize those 15 minutes? That is the first point. So first point is that when you get the question paper, so instead of going thoroughly throughout that, you just have that reading section, that is note making. Just have a look of that comprehension, not the other one which you are getting for subjective or objective question. This is about note making. So just go through that question bank, that is the comprehension one, first one, note making. So automatically you will get to know what? First thing is title. So make sure about the alignment also, heading, title. It should be very clear because I am telling you about marking scheme, the way you get marks in board. So when you read the comprehension, it's obvious that you will get to know about heading. So half mark, you get it at that time. Now again, just have a reading. That is the second look of that comprehension. Now randomly, you have a pencil in your hand. You are not supposed to write anything in your answer sheet, but you can have pencil. You are reading the question paper. So now with pencil, randomly divide it into 3 or 4 paragraphs. I'm repeating again, randomly on your question paper, just slight light, you divide it into 4 paragraphs. Maximum can be 5, minimum 4. So restrict to that. Don't go beyond that. So when you have just randomly underlined or divided into 4 paragraphs, now you are going to give subheadings. And I am just, you know, note making can be of tabular form also, different forms, but we follow indentation form. So what is indentation form? First thing is that when I have read that small part of that paragraph, I got the gist of that. So I will give subheading. So that subheading, when you are giving, make sure either it should be in capital letters or running. But when you are using running letters, you have to underline it. You have to use scale. But I am telling you again, you have to go for your time management also. So in time management, better you use caps. You are writing subheading, but make sure you are writing either capital letters or you have to underline it. So similarly, you are going to give second subheading, third subheading, 4 subheading. So this way you are dividing it into 4 paragraphs. Okay, so this is the first thing you have done, subheading, and make sure subheading should not comprise of a sentence. Omit subject, object, that should be the core of the sentence. That is exactly, you are going to use phrases. You are not supposed to use full sentence. It should be only phrase. Means you have to omit subject or object. Just like you got the comprehension related to discipline. So heading is discipline in the present time. So subheading, what are the points to keep in mind when you're following discipline? So you are writing subheadings 4 subheadings. So again I am telling you the marking scheme, if you are not able to do it perfectly, but still you are going to get marks. So your subheading and heading, you are going to get another half mark. So anyhow, if you are not going to write any of the sentence, you didn't get the time, you skip it, ultimately one mark is sure you are going to get. So subheadings you have written, that is the second step. Now third step, you just read this much paragraph. Again I am saying, you are not supposed to use your brain this time. You have to keep your brain for further question bank. So first thing is that here you are relaxed, you need not to mug up anything, you need not to use your brain, you are simply in a very very light way doing the things. So randomly in that paragraph you just underline some of the sentences, any sentence. This is not sure that you are going to write particular sentences. No, you have to underline some of the sentences in first paragraph, similarly in second paragraph, similarly in third paragraph. When I am telling you light way underline it in your comprehension, it means that there is some reason behind it. It should not be visible to examiner, means it should be visible to you that whichever the sentences you are going to shorten, it is in your question paper. Okay, so you have underlined those 3-4 sentences. Now you have to shorten those sentences. Now I'm just giving example that how you can shorten those sentences. Suppose there is line, our school is going to celebrate annual day on 24th November. This is full sentence. Okay, so now you have to shorten that sentence. How you can shorten? Celebration of annual day on 24th November. So you have skipped subject, object, the core point of the sentence you have written. Similarly, you are going to shorten other sentences which you have underlined in these paragraphs. Now how you are going to specify it? 1.1, 1.2, 1.3, 1.4. Mean those sentences which you have underlined, you are going to shorten those sentences and you are going to write here. Similarly, you can do with the second one, that is 2.1, 2.2, 2.3, 2.4, and similarly with the third one. Is it clear? Now here we have used content, we have shortened the sentences, we have given subsections, we have given heading. So similarly, we are going to ensure our content for one mark. Not two mark, you got it. Now, another thing is that, what is the second thing? When we are shortening the sentences, we are using abbreviation. Abbreviations are very important part of notebooking because you are going to get one mark for making these abbreviations. Now, abbreviation, first of all, what are the abbreviation? Abbreviations are the short forms. But first thing is that abbreviation, I can divide into three parts. First abbreviation, you know, it is short form. It is known as short form. Second one is contraction. And third one is acronym. Now, what are acronyms? I'll just take this first. Acronyms are the short form of name of any organization, name of any institution. Suppose I say USA. This is acronym, United States of America. If I say UK, United Kingdom. If I say PWS, Pertau World School. Similarly, I say IGNO. So, you know, one thing is that when you are writing acronym, make sure these are the name of the institutions or organization. You cannot randomly take a phrase and shorten it. No. It should be a particular name, a specific name of an institution. If you find that in paragraph, so you just circle it that I am going to use abbreviation of these names. This is acronym. Now, what is short form? Short form is very simple abbreviation. That is just like I say, especially. So instead of writing especially, I will write ESP. Okay, followed by a full stop. Means you are going to write first 2-3 letters of that particular word followed by a full stop. that is short form. Now, what is contraction? Contraction means you are going to use first letter and last letter of that particular word. Suppose if I am saying doctor, so I say DR. Similarly, I say engineer, then I will say ER. Now, if you are going to get this thing, how many abbreviation? Now, basic thing is that how many abbreviation you can use in a comprehension, a note making. You restrict yourself to 7 or 8 abbreviations. Don't write, don't exaggerate, don't fill your paper with around 20 or 22 abbreviation, because that will be the negative marking. You are using 4 subsection, so randomly 2 abbreviations, 2 abbreviations, 2 abbreviations. So 4, maximum 8 abbreviations you can use. I'm specifying again, not more than that. Just restrict yourself to 8 abbreviation. Now, how you're going to get 1 mark for that? When you finish note making, make a table. Okay? Make a table like that. Here you write the word, then you write the abbreviation which you have used for that. Suppose if I say the word is Pratap World School, okay, that means you have used that abbreviation for the name of the institution. Then in front of that you write PWS. Similarly, if you have written it for doctor, you just mention the abbreviation which you have used here. Then only you can get 1 mark. Otherwise, if you are using the abbreviation here, not mentioning here, you are not going to get marks. So make sure when you are making these abbreviation, you have to explain it at the end of the note making. This is the table which you are obviously going to write. Okay. Now, the another thing is use of symbols. Obviously, when you are shortening the sentence, and what exactly what we can shorten the sentence in what way? So you can use symbols. There are universal symbols, there are mathematical symbols. Just like universal symbol, nowadays SMS language you are using at the rate of, that is, less than, greater than, and example, then you can say etc. So you can use those symbols in these sentences also, which is most important. But symbols you are not going to mention in the table, because it is to be mentioned in the sentences only. Not sentences, sorry, it should be in phrases only, because when you're writing sentences, they are deducting your marks. So skip, obviously, from the beginning you can say that everything is explained to us in that way, that our mind is not ready to accept when we are shortening the things. Instead of writing I am going to school, if I say going to school, my mind is not able to accept it. But we have to simply explain what exactly is the purpose behind explaining note making in 11th and 12th. The reason, when you leave the school, you go to colleges, you go to universities, the professors are not having time to find out whether you are writing or not. They will come, they will deliver the lecture and they will go. So that time you have to be very fast. You have to note down, you have to jot down the points what the person is speaking. And then only you can explain to yourself later on. That is the purpose of note making. That you just note down what the person is speaking, and after that you can make your notes. So this is the purpose of explaining note making. Now, you got 4 marks for this. Okay, so now what is another 4 marks, because note making is of 8 marks. So when I have done note making, I ensured my 4 marks here: heading, subheading, shortening the sentences, indentation form, use of abbreviations, use of symbols. How I can get another 4? Children, that is very easy part. You know, in the beginning I told you to take a pencil and underline the lines in your question paper very, very light way, because at that time you have to be free of stress. Now those 4 marks you are definitely going to get, because just take those sentences, write in the summary. You are not going to do anything, because these are the sentences only which you have shortened, and now you are going to summarize that. All the shortened sentences which you have written in question paper, which you have marked in question paper, take those sentences, make a box, write summary, and those 4 marks you are definitely going to get. Nobody can take it from you. So that exactly is the presence of mind, टाइम मैनेजमेंट, बिकॉज नोट मेकिंग इज द ओनली थिंग इन 11th एंड 12th वेयर वी डोंट हैव टू, यू कैन से दैट, मग अप एनी थिंग, वेयर वी डोंट हैव टू फाइंड आउट द आंसर्स, वी डोंट हैव टू फोकस ऑन वोकैबुलरी, सिनोनियम, एंटोनियम्स. इट जस्ट ओनली प्रेजेंस ऑफ माइंड हाउ वी आर शॉर्टनिंग द थिंग्स. And this is very important that each and everyone get 8 marks for that. I'm sure that you will just go through it. If you have any doubt, you can ask me later on. And you will definitely do practice. And if you don't have any of the book, any textbook you take any of the comprehension and do the practice of note making in your class, in your notebooks also. And further, in the next session, we'll go for writing section, that will be our short composition. In the meantime, take care, stay healthy, stay safe. Thank you so much.